buoyage marker and fog signal. The development of a uniform system of buoyage throughout the world was of paramount importance for safe navigation at sea. As traffic lights are used to guide drivers on road, similarly, buoys and beacons are indispensable for guiding mariners at sea. For the sake of maintaining uniformity in buoyage system worldwide, IALA, the International Association of Marine Aids to Navigation and Lighthouse Authorities, divided the world into two regions, Region A and Region B, and the difference will be only on lateral marks and do not pertain to other marks. To make sure the marks or buoys is always visible and meaningful, shape, colors, and lights are used to differentiate them. IALA buoyage system provides 6 types of marks: lateral marks, cardinal marks, isolated danger marks, safe water marks, special marks, and emergency wreck marking buoys. The lateral marks help to indicate which side of the waterways is to be followed. The port marks should be kept to the vessel left side and starboard marks to its right. However, when a vessel travels downstream, it will be vice versa. In Region A, the color red of the lateral system is used to mark the port side of channels and the color of green for the starboard side. In Region B, the colors are in opposites. The local direction of buoyage is the direction taken by the mariners when approaching a harbour, river, estuary or other waterways from seaward, while general direction of buoyage is determined by the buoyage authorities, based whenever possible on the principle of following a clockwise direction around continents. In Region A, starboard lateral mark is green with cone, pillar or spar as shape of buoy marker. The top mark should be single green cone and retro reflector used is also green band. Their light is green and in 4 types of flashes, which continuous quick, single flashing, long flash and group flashing such as couple flash at a time. For lateral mark in Region A, all characteristic is about the same, except for the shape and top mark will be a can shape instead of cone, while the marker color and light should be in all red. Cardinal marks. Cardinal marks are used in conjunction with compass to indicate where the mariners may find the best navigable water. They take their name from the quadrant in which they are placed. They have the same color and same shape irrespective of Region A and B. There are 4 cardinal marks named after the 4 cardinal points of compass: north, south, east and west. Each mark can be distinguished from one another from their top marks, buoy color, and rhythm of light. When a cardinal mark is seen, remember that clear and navigable water lies on the name side of the mark. To remember the signs, north cardinal top marks points upwards, while the south top marks point downwards. East cardinal top marks pretty much takes the shape of an egg that can be associated with the Easter egg. West cardinal top mark can be compared to the waist of woman tapering towards the center. The rhythm of light can be related to the face of a clock. To remember the light sequences, think of a clock face. The long flash immediately after the group of flashes of south cardinal mark ensure that 6 flashes cannot be mistaken for 3 or 9. All cardinal marks exhibit white lights. The isolated danger marks. As the name suggests, these buoys are used to mark danger to shipping. They highlight and bring to the attention of mariners any hazard or dangers to safe navigation. These marks are erected or moored above the danger to alert mariners of any peril ahead. An isolated danger mark indicates that there is navigable water all around the mark. This mark can be distinguished from other marks by their top marks, which consist of 2 black spears, one above the other, and by their color: black with one or more red horizontal bands. The rhythm of light is group flashing of 2 that can be easily retained in memory by correlating it to its top mark, 2 black spear. Unlike other marks that use horizontal stripe, safe water mark is the only mark to use vertical stripes. Safe water mark does not point to any danger but specifies that safe navigable water is all around the marks. Safety watermarks are instrumental to mariners as they indicate the beginning of a mark channel. So when a mariner sees a safe watermark on chart, he should soon realize that he is approaching a channel. It is the demarcation between open seawater and confined water. It indicates the entrance to any port. It also points out the best point of passage under a fixed bridge. Safe watermark uses red ball as top watermark. Safe watermark can be used in a line to mark navigable safe water route through shallow area. Special mark are used to denote mariners area with special features. They do not play any major role in facilitating mariners in safe navigation. They only point out areas of certain interest to mariners. The nature of such area can be found by consulting the charts or sailing direction. Special marks may indicate spoil grounds, military exercise area, recreational zones, boundary of anchorage area, cables and pipelines, dead ends, mooring areas, protected areas, marine farms or aquaculture, oil wells, ocean data acquisition, which gather information about wind speed, pressure, salinity and temperature. This mark can be easily be demarcated from other buoys by their yellow color and top mark, which is cross. And finally, the emergency rag marking buoy. These buoys have come into existence much later compared to the other five types of marks. The sinking of MV Tricolor in the Dover Strait in 2002 introduced the emergency rag marking buoys in IALA buoyage system. The rag was struck further by two other ships, causing havoc damage to shipping and loss of life. After the incident, it was immediately necessary to mark such new danger so there is readily recognized by ship as new hazard and further collision are prevented from occurring. Emergency rag marking buoys mark newly discovered unsurveyed danger, which are yet to be announced and declared in nautical publication and charts. This buoy is placed as close as possible to the rig, and unlike other buoys, it is designed to provide a highly conspicuous visual and radio aid to navigation. We have now established why the buoyage is there, what each buoy represents and what it is look like. We need to now consider how we identify them from any other light at night. In order to find the light on the chart and be able to use it to fix the ship positions, we must be able to identify the light by its characteristic. There are four main characteristics to a light: rhythm, color, period, and intensity. For the rhythm, there are several examples with abbreviations on chart, such as fix, flashing, occulting, alternating, isophase, and Morse code flashes, and variety of light colors involved representing those. However, if there are no color listed, then it will be white. For period, it is the time taken for the light to complete one full cycle of on and off changes. While for the intensity, it is measured in candelas. Each light is fitted with a bulb or filament of fixed power or brightness. The most important factor that need to be known is how far away you will be able to see the light. This is broken down into three areas, that is the intensity of light, the prevailing visibility, the height of the light combined with the height of the eye of the observer. The range is based on visibility being 10 nautical miles, and this referred to as luminous range. The distance at which a certain light, such as lighthouse, is visible in clear weather. Bear in mind that visibility is rarely exactly 10 nautical miles, and that your height of eye may not be sufficient to overcome the curvature of the earth, and also depending on the power of the light. The ranges given on charts should be used only as rough guide, while the geographical range is importantly to be considered. By combining the various characteristics, it is possible to have a large number of lights within a small area that are all easily identifiable. Advantage is taken of this to provide the necessary distinction between each in the same area. Let's have some example likely to be read on charts. FL6 in 30s means a group of 6 white flashes in every 30 seconds. OCY 12.5 seconds means a yellow light with one occultation in every 12.5 seconds. Capital of FG means a fixed green light. ISO R means an isophase of a red light with an equal duration of light and darkness. Another thing is fog signal, which give an invaluable warning of danger, but their use for navigation is limited. Sound travels in unpredictable ways. However, sound could be heard at greatly varying distance. It is affected by atmospheric condition. There are also some areas of inaudible sound. In short notice, the fog signal may be inoperable as it could be too late and no accurate bearing of range information for sound or fog signal. Here are some of abbreviations of fog signal found on charts like diaphone, siren, reed, explosive, bell, gong, whistle, and horn. That's all for now. Thank you.